Welcome to Money Mornings with Marlena. Our title today is Stop Money Constipation. We all know how uncomfortable being constipated is. And if your money had a voice, it would say, please stop constipating me. Now, for some of you, this is funny. I laughed when I was given this title today because it was just so wild. Okay, stop money constipation. Just seemed funny, but it's not funny. It's a serious issue, and it affects every person on the planet, some more than others. Some were born into the poverty mindset, and they are restricted. They are constipated. They are constantly, you know, trying to force money into their lives, you know. And so what we want to do today is we want to assist whoever is willing to receive the help today that is available here. Number one, we are going to go into the mindset of a hoarder, okay? A hoarder is a person who lives in fear. Fear of not enough. Is that you? Do you hoard items in your home? Are you storing excess items in your garage to the point where you cannot even park your car? So it's wasting money. It's stopping up your money flow by having your car out in the elements. As time goes by, your car gets ruined by the weather and it's worth less. So it is a part of the money constipation. You are stopping the flow of receiving more money and the blessings that the universe has for you by cluttering up your home, cluttering up your garage, your attic, your closets, under your bed, all over the dressers. You have knickknacks everywhere. Okay, you have items from other people, relatives, people that passed on, you know, all these items are causing money constipation in your life. And I have helped over 20,000 people and climbing, okay, with many issues, but the top one is money. They come every day with a money issue, and I have to look into their situation. We have to go into the root of it, okay? And sometimes it takes, you know, several sessions with people to get them out of that, okay? It starts in your childhood. For some people, they were brought up in a home where the money was hard to come by. There was constant fighting. There was divorce, separation, cheating, abuse. All these factors factor into your adulthood and what goes on, okay? What I suggest today is you think about your home, all right, and your money, all right? If your home, okay, is constipated, it is going to be yelling and screaming at you as you look at it. And you're going to look at your rooms and go, ugh. And it brings your energy down, okay? Looking at clutter. It really drops the vibration in you and your home. And it stops your flow of money, believe it or not. Now, you have many items in your home that you do not need right now. And I'm talking to all of us. Every one of us has collections of something that we do not need. So if we are wise, we will grab those items during this week and we will sell them, okay, to bring in a flow of money. There is let go, offer up. Craigslist, eBay. There's your websites if you have one. There's garage sales. Okay. So that's one thing we can do to begin to relieve the constipation in our money. If your money is flowing but you'd like more, look into ways that you can support other people. All right? What are your gifts? What are your talents? Okay? What in those giftings can you do to help other people? And your money can increase immediately. As soon as you take action, the universe responds to you. All right? I'm going to go back in time. I had a serious issue that happened in my life, and I wrote down on a piece of paper my income and my outgo. Okay? My income was not enough to pay the major bills. Your major bills are your housing, then the power bill, and then underneath that comes the food bill. You do not need anything else, and that's the truth, okay? You just need a place to stay, all right? You need to have power on. And, you know, of course, we have to have water and food to survive, okay? You do not need to go shopping to buy new clothing and the best of everything, all right? Another thing you can cut down on the ways you are wasting money. You may go out every day and buy a coffee, $3 to $5. That adds up after 30 days. So look at the ways that you are wasting money every month. Make a list, okay? Cell phone. What are you paying a month for your cell phone? All right. Some people I know are paying $300 a month. They bought a phone for $700. And then, you know, they're worrying about their money. And I'm looking at them saying, there's one thing right there. Okay. I have a cell phone that is $20 a month. And I can do on my cell phone everything that everybody else can do. Isn't that amazing? Okay, so look at things like that. Your cable bill, all right? If you're having money issues, you got cable going, all right? Cut it down, all right? For a while, I lived without TV. I watched DVDs, and I utilized YouTube. Tuning into the shows I wanted to watch, music videos, whatever it took, all right? Till I got to the point where my finances were flowing, you know, in an excess. So how long is it going to take? It's up to you, all right? So make a list, okay, of your income, all right? So if you have a job right now and you make $300 or $500 a week, whatever that is, okay? Some make less, some make more. It all depends on you and your belief system and your lifestyle. And then your outgo. So what is your outgo right now compared to your income, all right? Most people are going to be just over broke, okay? J-O-B, they have a job, which to me is just over broke, all right? Because they'll make an income, and then what they do is they make their outgo, okay, at that same amount or more. So we need to look at the factors here and why people are doing that to themselves, all right? So sometimes you have to move, all right, into a more reasonable location, you know, just for a while. Say this is temporary, all right? Everything is temporary unless you want to make it permanent. So think about that. Choices. You have choices every single day to make. So what we want to do is we want to stop your money constipation. And we want to get the money flowing, okay, at an ever-increasing rate, correct? Everybody would like an excess of income, you know? So I have one client recently that wanted to know how to, you know, get their money flow back. And what had happened was they were in a relationship and it broke up. So they closed up their heart. They got depressed, of course, and all stuffed down the emotions. Their subconscious went into effect with saying, I'm not gonna bother dating. Every time I do, this happens, blah, blah. They had a story put in there. Then their money flow started to drop. All right. So now they're looking to date again and they can't seem to find a date. All right. Nobody would say yes to them. Okay. And we looked at it and we went back to that past relationship. And what had happened was they had decided that they weren't going to make enough money anymore. Because if they made money, then they would be able to take somebody out on a date. All right. And it's really wild how this stuff happens. So we went in and started to unravel all this stuff. And now they are dating again. Okay. And their money is flowing because they took on a business. Okay. And their job. So they started a side business. So they were helping people. They're using their gifts. And I've done that myself. I wrote a list of what I'm good at, what I like to do. And I utilized that. I went into business for myself, all right? And I started making incredible income, all right? And I wasn't only doing a side hustle, all right? I was cleaning homes. I had my own business. Not only homes, I was doing restaurant, bars, dance clubs, gyms, daycares, churches. I did so many different buildings. I would go into a place and, you know, say to them, who cleans here? And I had the guts. I was motivated and determined to see my results that I was looking for. Because when I wrote down my list, okay, of the income versus the outgo, all right, I saw that I had a need to create more income, okay? And I ended up with several businesses. Plus, I was selling on eBay, all right, at that time. And I was using my gifts of baking, and my baked goods went across the globe, all right? And also got featured in New York Times for my baked goods, which increased that business rapidly overnight. So I was enjoying it because I enjoyed baking, all right? I enjoyed cleaning. I was good at it, all right? So several things you can do. What are you good at? What do you like to do? This is where your money is. That's where your money is, all right? And don't ask anybody's advice. All right. Nobody can tell you what you're good at. All right. You know what you're good at. You know what you like to do. These things are exactly the way to open up your money flow. So let's focus on how to open up your money flow and stop money constipation immediately. All right. If you're in debt because of fear, we want to get you out of that. All right. And it's rather simple. All right. The first thing is get rid of everything in your home that you do not need, because that is debt. Okay. And that debt can be turned into money overnight. Somebody needs them items that you have. Somebody will pay you for that extra TV, old cell phone, extra computer, printer, radio, clothing, shoes, pocketbooks, wallets, you name it. Okay. Junk drawer stuff. Open up your junk drawer, take a photo of it, and sell it on eBay. You'll be surprised the money that will start coming in. All right. So look at the ways that you can create an extra income stream for yourself. I'm giving you some golden nuggets today. As the golden nuggets are coming down on the top of the screen here, working with me, I work with gold energy a lot. I work with the angels every day. They gave me this title and I bust out laughing. And I said, thank you for your sense of humor. But in all seriousness, we want to stop the money constipation. We want to get you out of debt. We want to clear your mind and the belief systems that are dragging you backwards. All right. I have another client that lost everything. All right. And from doing the wrong things, had a beautiful home, nice lifestyle, good job. Started hanging out with the wrong people, doing the wrong things, ended up in trouble, come out of the trouble, and wants to get back everything they lost. And I said, why? And they didn't have an answer. They were frozen. I said, why do you want to bring back the old life? All right, your old life has a nasty negative energy to it and is trying to bring you backwards. So see, that's sabotage. It's psychological, programmed into the brain to stay stuck, all right, and not take any action, all right, and complain and allow drama. So some families are full of drama. All right, so when you come out of that family, you have, you know, like a energy left over from them. And although you're trying to get rid of it and do everything you can, there are still signs of it being there. So it's good to actually look at yourself, look at your own life, look at the ways that you are sabotaging yourself. All right. Look at your home. Look at the ways that you are wasting money. All right. Buying that coffee every day instead of making it at home. Make your lunch at home. All right. If you are worrying about like vacation money, you know, things like that. You know what? A vacation is, first of all, de-stressing, right? Time off. So time off from worrying about money would be a vacation for some of you. Another thing is, why does it have to cost you money to enjoy yourself? All right? Why can't you just go to the park? Right? Why can't you just go to the beach? Why can't you go for a walk? All right? These are all free. Right? So think about things you can do that are enjoyable, that don't cost anything at all. All right. The universe supplied all this for us. All right. And exercise, walking is great. It moves energy. Your body needs to exercise. It needs to get off the sofa, get away from the computer and the cell phone. All right. Another thing is get a different cell phone if you're paying $300 a month for a cell phone. It's kind of crazy. All that money could be saved, all right? So think about also getting a jar and start putting some money in it for your vacation, okay, or something that you really want. I have a jar that's fun money, all right? Don't touch it for a year, all right? Look at your wallet. Look at your purse. Is it cluttered up? It's time to clean it out, throw out the old junk, get out all them receipts and gum papers and garbage, all right? Money thrown in your pocketbook, money ripped up, all torn up. Your money's yelling, you know, stop constipating me. If your money could yell, it would be yelling that right now, all right? So these are some of the things. I have another person that I call wasting it. Yelling about they don't have enough money. All right. And they have three storage bins, $200+ a month. But they don't have any money. Gee, I wonder why, I said to them. And I am, you know, right in your face. That's the way I deal with it. And I said, what's in there that you really need? Family stuff, this guy's stuff, hello. And you're paying for it. Why? Sell it. Get rid of it. Do something. Okay? When you get rid of that $600 bill a month, you will not have that story anymore. Why do you want to keep that story that you don't have any money and you can't pay this bill? And if you don't pay that one bill, you're telling me you're going to go to jail for a year. So why would you want to live in that kind of on the edge energy all the time? All right. There's a reason for that. And it's psychological. It's self-sabotage. It's money constipation is what it is. All right. A lot of you want to point the finger at somebody else and say, so-and-so, they're a hoarder. Right. Instead, we want to look at ourselves. We are the ones responsible for us. We are not responsible for anybody else, nor can we change anyone else. We can only change ourselves and our money story. So that's what I intend to do, is to help you stop your money constipation and get your money flowing once again. We cannot go to the drugstore and ask them for kaopeptate to help us with our money issues, okay? And I'm not making light of the situation. I'm just saying that to you because it's true. We have to go to the root of the root of the root of it and get down to business here and open up your money field for you. Opening up more avenues for you to create new money coming into your life without hesitation, without fear of taking a chance. Now, what if you started a business today and you made money? How would that feel? It would feel great. And you would know that the universe has your back. So utilize the information I just shared with you, and I would love to help you even deeper. So under the video in the description box, you will see my information, right? My email's there and my websites. And also when you look under the video and you email me, you can connect with me on my live telesummits, all right? I'm going to be on September 9th, which is Monday at 3 p.m. with Alara Canfield, and then again on the 19th on Awakening Heart Network, and I'd like you to join me. We are going to have a lot of fun. We are going to be talking live with people, answering questions, and doing all we can for each person. So make sure to be on the calls, subscribe to my channel here, share the videos, and when you subscribe, click the little bell icon that's right there on the right so that you will get the email notifications from YouTube when I upload a new video. This has been a very interesting talk today. So I hope you have enjoyed the information. If it has helped you in any way, leave a comment below. If it hasn't helped you, but it may help somebody else, please let them know about it. All right. That's why we're here. We're not here to do any harm. We're here to help you and assist you. So let's stop your money constipation in its tracks right now, and let's flush it down the drain where it belongs, okay? And may your money start showing up in your life in incredible ways. Have an awesome day creating something new for yourself. Thank you so much for your time. Much appreciated.